Praise be to Allah, the Lord of the world. May the peace and blessing of Allah be upon the Prophet. Dear listeners, life is a privilege and not a right. Life is given to us as a free gift by Almighty Allah, the Creator of the life. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made us to understand that this life is a privilege and not a right. And we have the duty of making good use of this life that we have. It is how we use this life that we determine what life is going to give us in return. And it is kama tadinu tudan. It is what you hoe that you pay. Wa kama tazra'u tahsud. It is what you sow that you reap. Wa kama ta'mal tujza. And it is the way you have done something that you are going to be rewarded. It is what you labor for that you are going to earn. Wa hal jazaa'u al-ihsan illa al-ihsan. Is there reward for good except good? Wa jazaa'u sayyi'atin sayyi'atun mithluha. And the reward for evil is evil of its kind. So man will always have what he has put forward. And in this life and the hereafter, man is going to have only what he has labored for. As the Quran has clearly said in many verses of the Quran, wa an laysa lil insani illa ma sa'a. And that man shall have what he has put forward. Wa anna sa'yahu sawfa yura. And that his labor will be seen. Wa an laysa lil insani illa ma sa'a. Wa anna sa'yahu sawfa yura thumma yujzahu al-jaza al-awfa. And that he will be rewarded with a full reward. Wa anna ila rabbika al-muntaha. And that the end result lies with Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So listeners, this is to tell you that this life is a privilege and we have the duty to make good use of this life and the time we have in this life. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in another verse of the Quran, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu, O you who believe, anfiqu mimma razaqnakum min qabli an ya'tiya ahadakum al-maut. Spend out of what we have given to you. What we have given to you of money, what we have given to you of your wealth, what we have given to you of your time, what we have given to you of your energy, what we have given to you of your knowledge and your talent and the skills that you have. Spend them in the path of Allah. Min qabli an ya'tiya ahadakum al-maut. Before death overtake any one of you, fayaqula rabbi. He will then say, Oh my Lord, laula akhartani ila ajalin qarib. If only you have given me respite for a very little time, la asaddaqa wa akun min as-salihin. I will believe in you. I will believe in your messengers. I will believe in the message of Islam and in the message of Al-Quran. Wa akun min as-salihin, and I will be among the righteous. I will be among the believers. I will be among your obedient servants. Wa lan yu'akhkhir Allahu nafsan idha jaa ajaluha. The reply from Allah, the Lord of the Creator, the Lord of the creations, will be, وَلَنْ يُؤَخِّرَ اللَّهُ نَفْسًا إِذَا جَاءَ أَجَلُهَا. Allah will not delay a soul when its time has come. وَاللَّهُ خَبِيرٌ بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ. And Allah has knowledge about everything that you do. The Prophet, peace be upon him, said in many traditions, one of which is, إِذَا مَاتَ ابْنُ آدَمٍ قَطَعَ عَنِهُ عَمَلُهُ. When the son of Adam dies, is cut off of every deed, is cut off of every opportunity, illa min thalatha, except from three, sadaqatin jariyah, continuous charity, like building a mosque, building an apartment for the orphans, for the widow, for the less privileged, aw ilmi yuntafa'u bi, or beneficial knowledge, like teaching people the book of Allah, teaching people Arabic language in order for them to understand the book of Allah, teaching people about their religion, and teaching people all other skills or things that will benefit them in this world and take them closer to Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Aw waladin salih yad'u lahu, or a righteous child that always remember his parents and pray for them and seek the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for them. So these are the three things that will be left for you after your demise from this world. The Prophet, peace be upon him, said in another tradition, يَتْبَعُ الْمَيِّتَ ثَلَاثَ, that when someone dies, three things will follow him to his grave. أَهْلُهُ وَمَالُهُ وَعَمَلُهُ. His family, his wealth, and his deed. يَرْجِعُ إِثْنَانْ وَيَبُكَ مَعَهُ وَاحِدْ. Two out of them will go back home, and it is only one that will remain with him. يَرْجِعُ أَهْلُهُ وَمَالُهُ. His property, his wealth, and his family will all go back home. وَيَبُكَ مَعَهُ عَمَلُهُ. It is his deed that will remain with him. So when we get to the grave, we are going to have as our companion our deeds. If the deeds that we have put forward are good, we are going to have them as good companions. Likewise, when they are evil, we are going to have our deeds as evil companions. The Prophet, peace be upon him, said in another narration, اِخْتَنِمْ خَمْسَ قَبْلَ خَمْسَ. Take advantage of five things before other five. حَيَاتَكَ قَبْلَ مَوْتِكَ. Your life before your death. Take advantage of your life. Take advantage of your soul. Take advantage of the time when you have power, when you are living, when you are in this world. قَبْلَ مَوْتِكَ. Before you find yourself in the grave. Before you find yourself in the house that is grave, that it will only be you. It will only be you. Your family will not be there. Your wealth will not be there with you. شَبَابَكَ قَبْلَ هَرَمِكَ. And your youthful age before your old age. That youthful age is very important in the life of man. That is when you have the figure, you have energy, you have everything, you have the most talent, opportunity. So everything that you have in this period, make good use of them. That is your youthful age. Wa ghinaka qabla faqrik. Your wealth before your poverty. The time that you have money, the time that you have job. Take advantage of this period before you are no more in your place of work. Before you don't have that money that you used to control in your bank account. Never forget to save for a period when you will not have money in your bank account. Wakadhalika, likewise the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, Faraghuka qabla shughlik. Your spare time before your busy time. The time that you have free period, take good advantage of it before you are busy. Umar radiallahu anhu, in the hadith of Al-Bukhari, said, تَفَقَّهُ قَبُلَ أَن تُسَوَّدُ. Seek for understanding of the religion before you are given position of responsibility. One of the scholars explained this statement of Umar and said, it is because when you are occupied with position, when you are in the position of authority, you will need knowledge to dispense this duty, and you will have no time to seek for it. You will have no time to seek for it. That is why it is important that you take advantage of your faragh, of your leisure time, before your busy time. The Prophet, peace be upon him, said, your ghinaka, he has mentioned, shababaka, your youthful age, your life before your death, then your wealth before your poverty, and then your what? Your wealth before your poverty, your leisure time before your busy time. And he mentioned another that we should take advantage of before the other thing. So we pray to Almighty Allah to always be with us. Dear listeners, let us take advantage of this opportunity. Let's take advantage of this life. So we pray to Almighty Allah to make it easy for us to benefit from our life before our death, and to benefit from our time before we don't have that time, and to benefit from our youthful age before we become old. So praise be to Allah, and the salutation of Allah be upon Prophet Muhammad wa sallallahu ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa ashabihi ajma'in. And thanks for listening.